Hello students, I hope you are all fine and in good health. I just started to explain few important questions. Later I will give you some more important question answers from this chapter. But basically all these are short questions, but you might find that I have exceeded the word limit. You can shorten it up, you can edit it according to your choice. But the main intention of explaining and giving out the short questions so that you can get an idea of how much you have to write and which type of questions will be there. These are some of the questions. Later, some more questions also will be given to you. As you know, in my previous audio presentation, I discussed three important questions, and at the same time, I highlighted some of the important parts of the story related with those questions and answers. Now I am moving on to question number 4, because the first three already I had explained in my previous audio presentation. Now I am moving on to fourth question. See the question, everyone, dear students. Why was Susan's case one that called all Dr. Manson's attention? Now, why this case requires the full concentration or the full focus or the full attention of Dr. Manson? What is the real reason behind it? Why this case demands so much of focus, so much of concentration on the part of Dr. Andrew Manson? What was the reason behind it? See, let me continue. Susan Morgan was about to bring forth her first baby after 20 years of married life. Now, at the very beginning only, at the very intro of this particular chapter, we get to know that Joe and Susan Morgan, they are happy married couples, but they were childless. Now, Susan Morgan was about to give birth to a child after 20 years of married life. So, not only Susan and Joe Morgan, but also Susan Morgan's mother, she was also awaiting for this particular childbirth. So it was a very delicate case, and definitely it needed maximum attention on the part of Andrew as a doctor. So I repeat, Susan Morgan was about to bring forth her first baby after 20 years of married life. Susan herself was keenly particular that the baby should survive any danger during her labor, even at the cost of her life. Now, Susan Morgan perhaps already made up her mind that she will successfully give birth to this child, no matter if it requires that she had to die. It doesn't matter to her if she had to die, but she already had made up her mind that she will give birth to this child by hook or by crook. Anyhow, no matter if she had to die, that is secondary. But the main primary focus is obviously she wanted to give birth to a child. Susan herself was keenly particular that the baby should survive any danger during her labor, even at the cost of her life. The minor family had been awaiting for this childbirth, and therefore, from the old woman to the rest, everyone trusted Dr. Manson's entire potential and skill for the baby's safety. So everyone had trust in Andrew, but most importantly, the husband of Susan Morgan by the name of Joe Morgan, he had blind faith in Andrew. And we get to know from the story only that he trusted Andrew Manson a lot. And he was equally confident that Andrew will pull it off, which thing, obviously the delivery case, Andrew will pull it off very successfully. So that ends question number 4. Dear students, now I am moving on to the second last one. As you see, question number 5. Look at the question, everyone. Why was Dr. Andrew Manson's mind heavy when he rushed to attend a case at Joe Morgan's residence? Why? Obviously, he was depressed because he had a quarrel with Christine, his girlfriend. And obviously, the hectic schedule at the hospital where he was working under a senior doctor by the name of Dr. Edward Page. So everything happened with Andrew. But being a doctor, you can't focus on all those emotional things while you are undergoing a treatment of a patient, because being a doctor, personal things should be kept aside and professional matter demands your attention, isn't it, dear students? So that is what Andrew did. No matter, Andrew was very much disturbed because he had a quarrelsome evening with Christine, his girlfriend, and obviously, as I told you, the hectic schedule of the hospital duty was there. Despite all that, and despite Andrew desperately wanted a 1 hour nap or a sleep, though by looking at the intensity of the case, of the medical case that was been given to him, he thought that it was not at all possible. But still, despite he is very much tired, he did his work brilliantly. And despite all the difficulties that he faced, because at some point of time, the midwife and the 70-year-old mother of Susan Morgan almost lost hope, all hope. But despite that, Andrew was very hopeful, courageous, determined, resolute, and optimistic that yes, I can save the life of the child. And that is what he did. Despite he was very exhausted, he never ever sidelined his duty. Never ever he decided to sneak out of this challenge. He was ready to fight for a better cause, and ultimately he was triumphant. That is the reason, dear students, I told you previously, it is not only the birth of a child or a birth of an infant, it is definitely also the birth of a doctor at the same time. So let me continue. Dr. Manson was already a lot of exhausted physically from his work and mentally because of his doubts concerning matrimony. Mentally also because of Christine, love affair with Christine, quarrel with Christine, what will be the outcome of his marriage with Christine, because some of his near and dear friends, even his senior Dr. Edward Page, they don't have a good conjugal married life. So he was thinking, what is the outcome of his future with Christine? He was worried about his own marriage that was yet to happen on one side, and on the other, he had a dilemma in his mind related to the shattered and chaotic married life of his friend. So he was in a dilemma that what will be related with his married life, and also he was thinking about the chaotic married life of his friends at the same time. So this dilemma was there in his mind. At the same time, he got a critical delivery case. Now he had to drive out all these thoughts, but we know that even while he was in the room of in the kitchen room, he was thinking about his affairs with Christine by looking fixedly at the fireplace in the kitchen room. But despite that, when duty demands or the call of duty was there, Andrew was obviously on his toes. Now, dear students, I am moving on to the final question of this segment, question number 6. Why had Susan instructed not to give her chloroform? What was the reason behind it? Susan had her life spent in anticipation of a baby for 20 years, and so was her mother, Joe, and so many others, because they awaited for almost 2 decades, and after that, it's a great opportunity for Susan to give birth to a child. So Susan was not eager to leave any stone unturned. Having grown old, she only wished if she could leave behind her baby for the family. I told you previously also, dear students, in this audio presentation, that no matter if she dies, she is never gonna bother about it. But her main target, her main wish was to give a child to this childless family. If that requires her to end her life, she had no sorrow for that. She is ready to die. But she is very much eager to give birth to a child. That is of more importance to her, not her life. But it was the brilliant presence of mind of Dr. Andrew Manson that her life was also saved. Remember, her life was also, it got a bit critical also after the delivery, as we know. But it was because of the presence of mind and the alert nature of Dr. Andrew mentioned that her life was also saved, along with the life of her newborn infant child. So let me repeat this line once again, dear students. Having grown old, she only wished if she could leave behind a baby for the family. Besides, in her society, infertility was considered to be a sin or a curse. That was the reason she was more than ever, she was very much desperate to have a child. Because in her society, to which society she actually belongs, barren. If a girl or a lady is barren, or infertility is considered as a curse or a sin. For fear of chloroform harming the baby, as believed by the minors, because they don't have a trust in modern medicine. Their mentality or their thought process or their ideology is very much old school based. That was the reason Andrew had to rush upstairs and had to convince her, I guess you all remember, that chloroform would not harm her, neither it would harm her child. Andrew had to convince her a lot that please, this chloroform or this anesthesia will actually help smoothly in the delivery operation of the child. Otherwise, she might be more weak in giving birth to a child. But because she was reluctant to use chloroform or anesthesia, Andrew had to rush upstairs and to convince her that there won't be any problem to her health, and basically there won't be any problem to the life of the newborn child. So let me continue. Infertility, I'm repeating this line once again, just bear with me, have patience and follow. Infertility was considered to be a curse for fear of chloroform harming the baby, as believed by the minors. She wanted to make sure that nothing harmed the baby against any amount of physical pain. She is ready to endure, or bear any amount of physical pain. But one important thing is that she was not at all ready to harm the child, but Andrew convinced her that if chloroform or anesthesia is given, then the delivery operation can be conducted very smoothly and there won't be any harm to the newborn infant child and there won't be any harm to her also. So that is it, dear students. I tried to explain these 6 questions. Kindly listen to this audio presentation, and definitely if there is any doubt, do let me know. Thank you, students. Thank you all.